Hey, from PVK.com, quick video here today on Hubertus knives and how to install the spring in a Hubertus knife. I recently had a customer who wanted to know how this was done, and I checked on YouTube and didn't see any videos, so I thought I'd go ahead and make one. These are all 8-centimeter Hubertus knives in various handle inlay and blade styles. This is a clip point blade with ram's horn. This is a mother of pearl inlay handle, Damascus with file work. A few of these knives are sprung. I picked ones that weren't sprung though, so I could show you and put in a spring. Yeah, this one's not sprung. They're a little hard to get out of there. You know, it's a great technique to get the blade out initially when there's no spring in there. I saw this at a knife show many years ago. Take a piece of paper, fold it like that, and stick it right in there. You can lift that out. So this is a rosewood handled with a clip point blade. This is a really nice ebony wood handle with a file work blade, also in clip point. This is a red pick bone inlay handle. And this is a buffalo horn handle. This is really cool because every buffalo horn handle is unique. No two are the same. This is white linen micarta. And then the last one is a natural stag bone inlay. And in the 8-centimeter, natural stag bone is our absolute favorite over here. It's just the coolest small pocket knife ever. I'm going to go ahead and put a spring into one of these knives. Show you how it's done. I'd like to say that you don't want to use light machine oil on Hubertus knives. It seems to gunk up the mechanisms because these knives have so much polish on them. There may be little deposits of polish in the pivot. So if you ever get a Hubertus knife that's kind of dragging, slowing down, not opening quickly, this great product, Quick Release, from the Latama Knife Company, which is latamaknives.net, or you can buy this from pvk.com, has the stuff Quick Release, and it's some kind of, whatever the compound is, it doesn't gunk any of compound that's in there, which I don't know, many people have had this knife, have had Hubertus knives, and added like WD-40 to them, and been surprised when the pivot kind of froze up. You know, after a while it goes away, but if you want quick relief, use quick release. I'm going to go ahead and put in the spring here. The spring catches under the little lip that's in the butt of the knife, and you insert it as such. And usually what I'll do is I'll use two springs to install one spring, because you need to pack that spring under that lip in the back. So I'll take one spring and I'll put it like this. I'll put some pressure there and I'll leverage it against the back of the blade to kind of push it in a little bit more. Okay, and then you can see it's about right there. It's not all the way in. See, it's still not, kind of not a really fast opening on that one. It's usually because the spring isn't packed in all the way. Take that and I'll stick that in there. Kind of crank it down. I bet you that'll work a ton better. Wow, how much faster that is. Isn't that cool? Alright, so one more time. I'm going to use this beautiful red pick bone one. Slip this in here. I'm going to take the spring. There's a skinny part and a fat part. Put the fat part in first. And I guess I'll go ahead and close the blade in. Get it kind of in there. See that little notch in there? That's where I'll put the other spring. And I'll kind of pack it in, leveraging it like that. So that it's notched. It's, you know, it's pressure fit into that little crevice down there. If you don't have two springs to do this with, you know, find a nail, you know, or a very small screwdriver, and you can do the same thing. And, you know, be aware of the fact that there's a really sharp blade right here. You know, so as you're doing this, you know, wow, it just came down and like nipped at my finger. You might want to wrap the blade off. I'll just wrap it with a little bit of chamois cloth there. Alright, so I think that's about it. Quickly though, I'm just going to show how to take a spring out. I'm not sure how successful I'll be at this. Let's see if we can get it on the first take. I'm going to use another spring. You could use a screwdriver or any kind of tool. And I'm going to stick it under that one and push on that till that spring sticks up. Then I have a pair of vice grips that I'll use to bite that spring that's sticking up. Get these tightened right. Well, it's a good bite on there. And then you can see that's all notched in there, and I'll just kind of press it out. Apply some leverage to that. Sometimes you can set this into a vise and use padding so that these shoulders won't get impacted or dented, and then just take, you know, like a rubber mallet or something and just knock the side of the plier, and that'll force it out. If you don't have all that stuff, another way to do it is with just like a nail or something, and you point the nail at the spring, and you take a hammer and you kind of tap at it. Get back in there. You kind of tap at it so that spring moves forward until it's freed up. So that's it for today. Thanks for tuning in. Check us out at pvk.com. Many more Hubertus in stock. Thank you.